Here we go again. Another graphic pack for the Vinci Resolve with under just $5. So, ladies and gentlemen, Titles Pro. What's up? Welcome back. First of all, thank you to our big brother. Is it this video? We have a giveaway. Yeah. But before we jump into the details, make sure you hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss an update from us. EasyEdit just launched their new Titles Pro Pack version 3. And again, we're not talking about just 10, 20, or even hundreds of elements. This V3 contains over 1,500 title templates. Let me say that again, 1,500 templates. The link will be down in the description below. And since you guys asked me a lot from my last motion graphic video, right here, about do I have any giveaway. This time, our big brother EasyEdit, they are so kind. They do care about my viewers, which is you, so thank you. They offer a giveaway to the viewers of this channel. We will talk about the rules and other stuff later on. So sit tight and stay tuned. So without further ado, let's open DaVinci Resolve. As always, in the folder, remember to download all the required fonts. It's very important that you download all of the font style, because usually if the effects doesn't work, like the viewer turns into black screen, it's most likely caused by the fonts. So double check if you've installed all of the variants of the fonts. Basically, you download this fonts archive here. Once you install of that, to install the title pack, head into the project files and simply double click this DRFX file. And then it will automatically pop up the installation window in DaVinci Resolve. Then click the install button. Then it will appear in the FX titles. All of these are simply motion title. They have this one line, two lines, callouts, glitch titles, cinematics, and etc. All of them are adjustable in the edit page. For example, you drag this title into your timeline. You can adjust the text and everything right here, like the position and the size and even the color of the text. Or if you want to do a specific change to a single word, like this one for example, you can right click at the text box and choose this character level styling and select this icon at the top right corner to go to the fusion page. Then select title notes and drag a word that you want to change in the preview and go into the inspector in the top right corner and select modifier. Then you can change the style of that word as you like. For example, I want to change this to yellow. Then adjust the size like that. If the character level styling is not able to choose, then you need to go to the insert and insert the character level styling instead and adjust the same as before. If you want to control the timing of the effects, you can change it to a compound clip by right click and new compound clip and make a cut. Select the part you want to change, then go to the inspector right under speed change, increase the speed of that part. You can also do another cut in the middle of the animation, then freeze that frame, then adjust the length to suit your edit. And if you want to go back and change the style of the title, simply just right click and open in timeline. They also give you these good old callouts. There are a lot of ways to track the callouts. One cleanest way is to use a tracker in Fusion Page, but if you don't want to mess with Fusion Page, you can do the normal keyframe from my last video. So in this video instead, I'll use a tracker. So head into Fusion Page and click at your media in node and hold shift and space and search for the tracker. Then hit enter. Then it will add a tracker node into your node tree. Then there will be a tracker window pop up in the viewer. Then you need to click this small square at the top left of the window and drag it to the object that you want to track. You can resize the window so that it doesn't take too long to process. The larger the window, the longer it needs to track. And there's an outer square around the main square as well. This is the threshold where you want DaVinci to search for, so I'll also make it smaller. Then you go into the inspector and click this track forward or backwards. And wait until it is done, go to the operation tab in the inspector and change the operation mode to match move and change the merge to foreground over background, which is the default one, so we don't need to do that. Then open the effects tab under templates in the edit and titles, then find your favorite callouts. For example, this one, drag it into your node tree, and then drag the output of the callouts and insert it into the green inputs of the tracker, which is the foreground. Then you position it and resize it and customize the text and color. It will automatically follow the tracker. there's a bunch of titles for you to play with. Like for example, if you want to do a tech review, they have this digital one or glitch title. Or let's say if you're in a fashion niche, they also have this fashion title. For example, if you want to promote your own streetwear brand, you can either use this fashion title or sports title. Or even if you want some cinematic title, they also include that in the pack as well. Or if you want to add a countdown timer in your video to do some short ads or say thank you to your audience, some like, I want to take this part of the video to thank you to all of my viewers that watch my video and have a really great feedback, which I really learned a lot from you, and it opened up a lot of opportunity for me here. And if you like this kind of content and giveaway, please like and subscribe. I'll keep creating, so thank you. Something like that, you can easily do it with this pack. They also includes a bunch of background, which is in the generator in effects tab, where you just need to drag it into your timeline, as same as the title, and adjust the color as you like. Then stretch the background to fit your needs. And some overlay effects, like if you want to take a picture of me in the middle of the video, like that. Then under effects category, they have includes both horizontal and vertical overlay in case you want to use it in a vertical aspect. And to use the overlay, you would need to have some clip, whether it's a video, photo, adjustment, or a compound clip. So basically, you simply just drag the overlay into your clip and start adjust it from that. It now, the most important thing, the price. At first, I thought you're gonna be somewhere around $100. No, it's not. What about $50? No, it's not. $34. Let me say that again, $34. Links down below. Let's say if you're running on a really tight budget with under $50 and in return you get over 1,500 elements, this deal is a complete no-brainer. Do I need to do that calculation for you again? If you divide that $34 with 1,500 templates, it's only cost you 2 cents per title. Or let's say if you're doing a part-time job, you only need to work for just 2 days and you can already afford this pack. Well, it depends on where you are in the world. But with $34, this is hands down the most worth to pay title pack in 2023. And last but not least, giveaway. Easier, they also offer a giveaway for you guys. And in order for you to participate this giveaway, you need to like this video, subscribe this channel, and comment down Titles Pro V3 below. Then we will do a random pick for a winner. That's it. Easy, right? And as always, if you enjoyed this video, remember to like and subscribe. If you have any feedback, leave them down in the comment below. I do learn a lot from you. And thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Happy grading. Bye. Oh, we'll announce the winner of the giveaway in the next 2 weeks. Cut.